Hello, everybody. It is Connor. We are back. We're the One Leeds Watchalong. I just ran to the co-op and I'm bloody knackered. Hope you're all doing fantastically well. We're back here. Thanks for tuning in. We've got a lot to talk about. Make sure you download it. SofaScore, everybody. We've got the lineups on the screen. Leeds United going up against Wednesday. Come on, Wednesday. Tonight, the Yorkshire Derby. And we're ready for it, aren't we? We're absolutely ready for this. And yeah, I'm buzzing for this one. Looking at a Leeds win. Let's just adjust the camera. A few technical issues, as always. Match on together. Yeah, keep the comments coming in, everybody. Go for this camera for this one, I think. Oh, yeah. Beautiful. Absolutely beautiful. Happy with the lineup, mate. I am, mate. I'm sort of, I say I'm happy with it. It's a bit of an odd one, to be honest with you. I think I'd have liked to see James in this one. I would have liked to have seen James. Byram is an interesting one. I can see a few people saying a bit worried about Firpo as well. I completely understand that. I thought the balance of Byram in there would have been okay for this one. I would have liked to see Joseph, but I understand why he's not in there as well. But let's get a couple of things sorted here. Not keen on this lineup. Baby, don't hurt me no more. Sorry about this, guys. A few technical issues. I'm just going to move the laptop a little bit closer. Ooh. Looks like we're going to have to do it on the laptop. Oh. Getting the muscles in there. How are we all doing anyway? Let us know in the comment section below. Yeah, what we're thinking for tonight, everybody. What we're thinking. Let's go with a couple of score predictions. Nonto to score. Why leave James out when he got the winner against Stoke? Don't get it unless James is carrying an injury. We are due a top-class performance. Hopefully, we've learned from our mistakes against the dog botherers last weekend. Yeah, you're right, mate. It's a massive game for us tonight. It's a huge weekend for Leeds United in terms of projection and where we could be. Guys, look. I have got a timer sorted. Are you happy? Can we get a light? Because I've actually got a timer. Look at this. Look, I'll even show you. Are you ready? Look at this. Right, are you ready? Are you steady? Can we get a like for that? Connor's got a timer sorted. Bosh. There we go, everybody. So no more complaining. That took me a long time to get sorted. So hope you appreciate the timer. We've got your instant match reaction immediately after this as well, everybody. But shout out to all of you guys who are here for this one. The reason I'm doing this is because it's Sheffield Wednesday. It's a Yorkshire derby. I'll try to do it on the odd occasion. I do prefer, I'll be honest with you guys, the analysis side of football and doing a bit of content creation for you guys on the analysis side of it. The sort of watch-along stuff I don't mind, but it's definitely, I wouldn't say it was my favourite. That might change. But let's have a look at the starting lineup today anyway. We've got Elan Meli in net. We've got Archie Gray at right back. I'd have kept Robertson. And I would have put a few changes in for this one, but it's just my opinion. It doesn't mean that would be the right way forward. Rodon and Ampadu's fine at the back for me. Firpo, I'd have gone Byram. I would have just felt for a Yorkshire derby. It'd have been perfect for him, this one. Grev and Kamara in the middle. I shared a stat on Twitter this morning, which was that Leeds United have got the lowest switches, or the second lowest switches in the division this season. Can you believe that? And that's not, it's not notoriously a bad thing, but with Marcelo Bielsa, we were the top. And the reason behind that is because you get Calvin Phillips in that pivot, just switching it immediately. And you get wingers against fullbacks. straight away. It'd be direct competition straight away, but Leeds will move it. 3, 4, 5, 6 passes, then it'll get to the winger. And I just think we have to be a little bit quicker in those actions, to be honest with you. Nonto will score, I think, says Brandon. AJL, Francis, Connor. Francis all the way, mate. I'm an MMA guy. I'm not a boxing guy. I don't mind boxing. I don't mind boxing at all. But I'll tell you what boxing is doing at this moment in time. It's getting the fight sorted. I'll tell you who I am absolutely pissed off at. It's Jake Paul. What an absolute, oh my God, like what an absolutely horrible person. And I don't normally say stuff like that, but Jake Paul, get Mike Tyson when he's nearly 60, mate. Well done, Jake. Why don't you fight someone your own age, mate? Oh yeah, you didn't lost. Glad you're in a watch along. I get nailed for even suggesting that Joseph should get a chunk of time in this game. Of course you do, mate, because it's a different opinion. And if you don't go with the status quo, you don't get the likes. So yeah, man, 100%. Just listen, you do you, mate, and you have your opinion. Don't conform. How are you finding your new digs, pal? I'm finding it really good, actually, mate. Yeah, I hope you guys are sort of enjoying the content. It took me a while to get into it, to be honest with you, because we had a few internet problems for 2 weeks. I didn't have internet, and I was managing to still get content out, which I was pretty proud of myself for. But yeah, 100%. Yeah, we'll have to wait and see, mate. We'll have to wait and see. Hello, Connor. In here. In it, what is that fight? Netflix Live. Yeah, I just don't get it, mate. I just don't understand why. Why is he doing it? I just can't be doing with him, mate. I can't be doing with him. He's a weird, weird guy. Fight someone your own age, mate. No, don't take on poor Mike Tyson, who's like 60 years old. Is your mic... Hold on, my mic not be ready. Is my mic not ready? Apologies. Here we go. Are we better now? We better? yeah, all good. Let's have a look. Joe's in the building. Hi, Joe. Let's have a look. Get the beers in, Connor.
Oh, my God. It's as if
you were just here, mate. Here we go. Don't you worry about it, mate. What have you guys got tonight? You might have a squash. You might have a tea. You might have a coffee. You might have a wine. Whatever you might have. It might be 10 o'clock in the morning. And you might have a water. No problem with me whatsoever. But it's a Friday night. Leeds are playing Sheffield Wednesday. It's a special one. I've got the Tisky in for this one. I'll tell you what, Paul. It's not recent videos, though, mate. It's not recent videos. Tyson, that is not his recent videos. That's 4 years ago. Zoe says, good to have you back on the live watchongs, mate. Thank you, Zoe. Hope you're all good. Hope you're all good. Feels so odd thinking about must wins for the team near the top of the league. That's the odd season we're competing in. Yeah, 100%. Bit of a weird one, isn't it? But it is. It's listen, two teams in form. Two teams in form. So let's hope that we can get this one done. Let's hope that we can get this one done. It's a massive game. They're all up for it. I think they've got a sellout for this one as well. Yeah, so yeah, cheers, mate. Appreciate that. There's a lot of very good channels out there, though, so keep subscribing to those guys, of course. Yeah, of course, we all offer different things. Have I just got... It better not be a non-alcoholic. Oh, it's an alcoholic. Thank goodness for me. Thank goodness for me. Our lineup tonight... is more than good enough to put this lot away. Sad James, save James, go knack at their defence. Yeah, it could be. Shout out to Geno as well. Yeah, it could be a great call, mate. It could be a great call. And I'm interested to see. I'm really interested to see how this one's going to pan out. But I'm expecting a Leeds win. Nothing short of that. The sort of annoyance with me is A, Andy Hinchcliffe's done a special on Danny Roll already, which is annoying me. Number two, or B, I should say, is that Barry Bannon's starting for this one, who's probably not their most important player. But we should be good enough. We should be good enough. More than good enough to get this one sorted. So I'm not really that worried about this one. They're looking good, but we need to have learnt from Huddersfield. So hopefully we have. Yorkshire Decaf, good man. Good man. Let's have a look. You doing Millwall, mate? I might be doing Kev. Might be doing. I've not. Oh, that's what Joe messaged me about. Yeah, I'll give him a bell back, mate. I'll give him a bell back. Yorkshire Decaf.
No, mate, not on my side. I'm nearly 31 years of age. I've got no interest in competing. I just do this for the love of it. No, not on my side. Hi, Connor, watching along from Niagara, Canada on the zone. Shout out to you, my friend. Hope you're all good. Keep getting your comments in, everybody. Yeah, shout out to Chronicles, mate. I really appreciate that donation. Take a point. That's just lame. Yeah, not for me, buddy. Not for me. Look at the Sheffield Wednesday sponsor. It's A-up. I've been to Sheffield Wednesday multiple times because I used to live there for about 5 years. And yeah, it is an interesting place. Very similar Hillsborough to Elland Road, but Hillsborough just seems massive. I don't know what it is, but it does seem absolutely massive. Will you get Joe on the channel again, Connor? Yeah, he's more than welcome. More than welcome, mate. Of course he is. Cheeky innocent smoothie for me. Love that, Cade. Love that. Connor, we have no midfielders on to bring on if we need to energise that area. They're all starting. Yeah, shout out. Michael, I don't think you're wrong there, mate. Come on, Leeds from Malaga. Sergio, I have just booked, just because Malaga was in my headspace today. I have just booked a holiday away to Gran Canaria. So I'm going to be bringing Leeds on tour to Gran Canaria, which I'm very excited about. Have any of you guys ever been to Gran Canaria? Look how badly I've poured that. I've now got an apple juice, which is absolutely fantastic. Terrible. What have I done? I've absolutely killed that beer. Steely Man says, if we are still today, I'll be annoyed. We have to grab it early on, just overwhelm them. Yeah, I agree. Completely agree, mate. It's got to be an early goal for Leeds United. Come on, Leeds from Worcester. Yeah, shout out. Martin says Gran Canaria is nice. That's good. I need Rutter 10 out of 10 tonight. I agree, Brandon. Big game for him. I think he's been off it. I think a lot of them have been off it, really, the last two or three games. Oh, dearie me. Woo! Right. Here we go. Sheffield Wednesday versus Leeds United. A big one. Barry Bannon is still alive. Jeez, he is, mate. Barry Bannon is very much alive and kicking. Hire a car and drive inland. Yeah, will do, man. David says, yes, I live in Lanzarote. What's good about the Watchalong is we talk about random stuff. Yeah, a lot of people just like the conversation, don't they, when it comes to Watchalongs. Leeds in the pink, the fruit salad kit. Goodness, mate. Yeah, greasy glass kills the beer. I think it, to be honest, mate, the glass is warm. I think that's what's killed it a little bit. Why not Roberts? I just think he wants to go with what he knows, really. So they've gone Beadle in net, Gaz Beadle, Jody Shaw, Valentin, Bernard, Diaby, Femewu, Palmer, Bannon, Marvin Jones. That midfield's terrible. Gassama, Masaba, Ukpo's had a really good season so far. Listen, we've got to be doing this lot. In Arctic, Gray, Rodon, Ampadu, Firpo. Then we've got Gruev, Kamara, Nonto, Rutter, Somerville, Bamford. Yeah, it should be a big win this for Leeds United. Scared of wearing blue, Leeds. Go for Xmas regularly. Player del Ingle and Puerto Rico, Gran Canaria. So I'm going to the first one, Playa del Ingles. Jeremy, let me know how that is, mate. Let me know some nice restaurants. You know, got to impress the missus with a bit of knowledge, you know. Got to pretend that I've done some research. So, yeah, shout out to you, mate. Connor, if we lose, do you think top two is out of the question? I don't think it's out of the question, mate, but I think it's going to be hard. But oh my God, I'm so excited to get this timer going. Guys, I've been badgered about this timer for so long and I've got it sorted. And I've actually had to pay to get this sorted. So if you guys wouldn't mind and download SofaScore, link in the description below, that would help me a lot. Shout out to everybody in the chat. Please make sure you're liking the content as well. Probably going to be a one-off watch along. Don't do it that many times. As I say, for a couple of you who've just joined, I did the watch alongs quite a bit, and I do enjoy the interaction. I think I just prefer the analysis. I like sitting down watching games and making a lot of notes, and in the watch alongs I can't do that as much. But we are going to be back here after the game for a little bit of live content. If you want to stick around. Uh, Have Leeds put Brendan Aaronson for sale, Connor? Not yet, mate. I don't think so. Oh, they're doing the chant. And it's Io Sheffield Wednesday. Come on, Wednesday. Oh, it'd be good to stuff them tonight. Be good to stuff them. It really would. It'd be nice. I like the kit. Aaronson, yes. Connor brings in the views. Just embrace it. I don't really do it for that though, mate. I do this just, I think if I lost track of why I did this and I just did it for views, I would probably quit because I do this because I love it. I do this because I absolutely love talking about Leeds. And when I lose that, that's probably when I'll give up, which I won't do. Don't worry. But yeah, I'm not all about the views, to be honest with you. I just enjoy talking about Leeds. But I hope it's unique what I do bring to you guys. I'm very aware of that and conscious of I constantly want to, hopefully, you know, maybe with a few of my comments, help you guys learn something. And I've said this before, I hope you make me learn something as well. I hope you take something away from the channel every time. But yeah, we're about to kick off now on my stream. So I know you guys enjoy starting and lining up with me. So I will start the buzzer. So the tracker is on top. It is Palmer taking the kick. Looks like it's going to be in about 3, 2, 1. Bosh, here we go. So we are off. And I'm turning my notifications off. Wednesday kicking from right to left. Up the boys in white. And I mean pink, fruit salad, whatever the hell it is. Wednesday's terrible pitch as always. And they're shooting from right to left. Yeah, it does elevate the channel as well, right? Yeah, I guess you're right, mate. I guess you're right. Another team's cup final tonight. That pitch is awful. It's always awful. But anyway, Nonto wrestling with Marvin Johnson here, and Archie Gray loses out a little bit, but Leeds win the ball back. Willie Nonto, well, lovely little interchange by Leeds. The fruit salads have the ball. Archie Gray's on the deck, and already you can see Sheffield Wednesday just moulding into a compact midfield here as Crescencio Somerville has the ball. Leeds just dictating possession a little bit for the first 50-odd seconds. Lovely little interchange there, and Leeds should be having a free kick there, but another dopey bastard referee doesn't give us the free kick. Leeds win the ball back in Sheffield Wednesday's half, but it goes out for a Wednesday throw-in. And the first little interchange there, the first little duel, indicates maybe that the referee isn't going to be up to much in this game. But yeah, heard they love it on Twitter as well. Foul, nice graphics. Thanks, Max. Spent a couple of hours doing it myself today. Anyway, let's get going. But like you've all quite rightly said, the pitch is absolutely atrocious, which is always nice to see. So Elan Melle at the back. It looks like, oh, it's a brilliant away end, to be fair. It's always a really, really good away end Wednesday. I'm always a big fan of it. That, Preston, Blackburn, Barnsley, always really good away ends. Anyway, Leeds have the ball. Junior Firpo has it now, plays the ball inside. Bamford tackled on the back there, and it looks like it's a Leeds United free kick inside. Wednesday's half. Looks like Bambo Diaby, that ex-Barnsley player there at the back. Kamara, Gruev. I need to see these two get forward a little bit more. I need to see a few more switches. And this is where I get a little bit frustrated sometimes with Leeds, because the wingers are isolated, everybody. We have wingers isolated against fullbacks. Really good play by Willie Nonto. Archie Gray on that right-hand side. Ball played in. Here we go. Jorginho. Oh, Rutte, you've got to do better, fella. Slices it right foot. And that's a real opportunity for Leeds United. Now, there is an argument. Yeah, nice little interchange on the right-hand side here by Willie Nonto and Archie Gray, which is great to see early on. Archie Gray with a really penetrating run on that right side, played the ball and fired it across. Bamford sets up really nicely, Rutter. And I'll be honest with you guys, I think he should have done better there on his right side. There's an argument, if you're watching the game, it had got blocked. There was two defenders sliding in. But for me, Rutter at least has to hit the target there. 0-0. Sheffield Wednesday, Leeds United. It looks like my scoreboard, for whatever reason, has just stopped there. I don't know why. Apologies for that, everybody. Should be back running now. Yes, it is. Yeah, I don't know why he went with that foot there, to be quite honest with you. Anyway, Sheffield Wednesday, get rid of it. Let me just adjust the time. Oh, and it's good defending there from Ethan Ampadu. It was Wednesday press high. I'm just going to elongate that time a little bit there, everybody, because for some reason, there we go. We're bang on the money now. Don't you worry about that. Composure, 10-minute goal kicks again. Yeah, I think Rutter should have done better there, Liam. You bang on the money. Junior Firpo here with the throw-in for Leeds United. But what you're going to get with Sheffield Wednesday, everybody, is a high press. You're always going to get a high press. So it's going to be fascinating to see how that's going to work with the Leeds United team, who are quite good on the ball. And when I say quite good, I mean very good. Cleared anyway from Gaz Beadle in net for Sheffield Wednesday. Can Leeds get the ball down now? Patrick Bamford, is he offside? Poor touch. Sheffield Wednesday win the ball back now in their own half. It's a bit frantic earlier on. Wednesday on the right-hand side now, coming forward. Nice little interchange. And they're in on the right-hand side here. Can Grove get to it? Gets skinned way too easily. Wednesday play the ball in. Good interception there. And Leeds win the second ball. They're all over Rutter like a hot rash. Like, can we have a foul there, referee? Jorginho Rutter gets Leeds out of a bit of bother there. Palmer bringing down the tall, athletic Leeds United central midfielder. Ethan Ampadu playing in a back two, of course, tonight with Joe Rodon. Joe Rodon has the ball on that right-hand side, plays it back to Ethan Ampadu. The pairing looking silky, both tonight in their white boots. Ball played back to Elan of Meliershire. Melier with his distribution has to be good tonight. Plays the ball out. Nice splitting of a midfield there by Glenn Kamara and Grueva. Like to see that. Don't want to see them too compact in this game. Christensen here, Somerville, plays the ball forward with an overlapping. Junior Firpo has to get there. Plays the ball in. And he got bundled in the back there. It's a Leeds United corner. I believe Firpo, he's offside. You should not be offside there, Junior Firpo. You can look at the line. Firpo overlaps the right back there. But guys, it's a massive frustration for me when you get wingers who are looking across the line off fullbacks and they can see the line and he's offside because he's overcompensating for his pace there. It's a real shame there. But yeah, should have been better there, Junior Firpo. Should have been a lot better. Ball kicked out anyway. Yeah, but I agree, everybody. Should have done better there. Should have done a lot better. Anyway, Leeds 50-50. I can't believe 5 minutes has gone already, to be quite honest with you. But that is the life of football. Ugbo up front there. Looks like he was holding his hamstring a little bit there, which is interesting. Because that obviously, you know, would take him off the pitch there. But Leeds United have, it looks like a windy night at Hillsborough there as well. It's always an absolute dire. I'm a second and a half behind now, apparently. okay, we'll go. How about that? There we go. Is that a little bit better? Ian Pervader obviously on the bench tonight for Wednesday. Being a Leeds United product, he can't play. Anyway, Ilan Melier clears the ball. It's bad, but really bad distribution from Ilan Melier. Give Patrick Bamford absolutely no chance there. Sheffield Wednesday have the ball now. Gary Beadle in there. I've got to stop calling him Gary Beadle. Geordie Shaw reference for you losers like me. Sheffield Wednesday play the ball out from the back. Listen, I think Sheffield Wednesday are going to be a lot better in this game at recovery high up the pitch and just a high press because I don't think quality on the ball is their thing, to be honest with you. I think it's just a lot of chance 50-50. As you can tell, it's the exact same game as Huddersfield already. It's scruffy. There's fouls. Leeds have just got to work their way around that because, you know, this can't be a constant thing, a constant rhetoric with Leeds. It's got to be something where we get this over the line a little bit better. Anyway, Leeds United a little bit, you know, more efficiently playing out from the back here. Okay, so we have Ethan Ampadu playing a long ball. Lovely. That's what we like to see. Long ball from Ethan Ampadu. Patrick Bamford wins the header. Brilliant from Bamford. Nonto receives the second ball here and Leeds United are advancing up the pitch. Archie Gray comes into that central space and it's a poor ball from Willie Nonto. Who was that to, Willie? There needs to be a name on it. Archie picked it because he didn't know where it was going. He thought he was going to lose the ball there. But it has to be said so far, Archie Gray's probably been Leeds United's best player. The overlaps are always there. The underlaps are always there. A really well done from Patrick Bamford there. A long ball from Ethan Ampadu. We can go direct if we're winning the second balls. Long ball from Ethan Ampadu, picked up there by Patrick Bamford in the air. Leeds United have a, whatever Wednesday have a. Have a goal kick, which they've just bunned out of play. And the keeper looks about 10 years old. Good evening, Connor. Sheffield have a pacey team, need to be careful. You're right, mate. You're right. Also, what minute are you on, Connor? Oh, did you know what, James? I love you, mate, but I'm not going to answer that question. I've been trying to get a timer sorted, mate, all day. And if you can't spot the timer, I'm upset, mate. Sheffield Wednesday player's just gone down. He's all over Somerville like a rash. And like a, get up, you child. Get up. And he's gone down like a sack of spuds and tried to get Somerville sent off there. Oh my God, that is the most pathetic thing you'll ever see. He's not even... Look at this, the state of it. Sheffield Wednesday player. Look at the state of you, mate. Oh, dearie me. He just flung himself to the floor. What's he called? No idea, never heard of him. Somerville's got to be careful, though, not to get in a battle, because, you know, we've got to play around that, because if we're just going directly to Somerville every time, everybody, we know what's going to happen. It's going to be Huddersfield 2.0 settings. We've got to start playing around that. We've got to start playing around it. Anyway, Ethan Ampadu on the ball here. Ilan Mele. Joe Rodon. Can we go along? Rodon looking for an option, doesn't find one. Archie Gray, unlocking. Tried to look for Willie Nonto there. It's a poor touch there from Rutter, but he's still got it on this right-hand side now. Taking the position of Willie Nonto here. Archie Gray on the ball, playing the ball inside. Joe Rodon, nice little interplay there with Ethan Ampadu. Ethan Ampadu looking for Glenn Kamara. Glenn Kamara needs to open his body up a little bit here. Does well. Lovely option there from Crescencio Somerville. Glenn Kamara, Somerville. It doesn't need to be so quick, does it, everybody? We all know what we're talking about here when it comes to Leeds United. You know, those really quick interchanges. Doesn't always need to be that way. I'd love to see us spread the ball a little bit more out wide, but we just don't do that. We've got more of the Jesse Marshes than we did in under Marcelo Bielsa. Bielsa was so expansive, and we're just not like that. We short pass it across the pitch. And when we short pass it across the pitch, it enables Sheffield Wednesday to also move across the pitch, which sort of takes out, as we can see right now, Crescencio Somerville on the ball, and he's pressing Sheffield Wednesday win the ball back. Barry Bannon on the ball here. Leeds pressing straight away. Ugbo on the ball. But this is where, you know, a long ball, everybody, a long ball alleviates that pressure straight away, and it's a 1v1 option. And a problem for the opposition team. And I don't understand why Daniel Farke tactically doesn't use that for Leeds United. I don't understand it. We just pass laterally like that across the midfield. Then it gets to the you know, the winger. And we're looking at a situation here where Archie Gray is 1v1 against their winger, does really, really well. Barry Bannon chips the ball in. Crescencio Somerville knocks it out. And it's a Sheffield Wednesday corner completely needless to concede that. It was scrappy. It was bitty. This is where Leeds have got to be careful here, because already it's a crap pitch like it was at Huddersfield. Bannon's got a couple more touches than we'd like, and they're getting it's the first corner of the day. But Leeds, I wouldn't say, have been ultra impressive in these first 10 minutes. Barry Bannon with a corner, short corner. Marvin Johnson. They're looking for Bannon again. Can Leeds close down? Leeds have done really, really well there. And it's really well defended by Leeds United there. And if, in all honesty, from Sheffield Wednesday's perspective, that's very disappointing. They've had a corner on about 11 minutes, and you just put that in the box on Ilan Melier, and they've decided to try pass it from a short corner. I don't care. You don't care. It is what it is. Over 500 career games, says at 14-14, and Bannon's still classy in this division. Yeah, he's a good player, and he's just difficult. I think he's difficult to mark, isn't he? Switching ball from one player to the other. Yes, Connor, I do worry about the game tonight, mate. I do, mate. Going to be 1-1. How do Wednesday go short on the corner? Haven't they watched us? Come on, Leeds, get the win to go second and hopefully stay in the top two. Good work, Connor. Yeah, shout out to you, mate. For all the Leeds people here, Rhino's 4-0 down to the Lee. Yeah, Rhino's not having an amazing campaign either this season. Anyway, here we go. Marvin Johnson at the back. Guys, please make sure you like the content as well. You just make sure it ranks higher in the algorithm. That'd be fantastic. Sheffield Wednesday, getting into this a little bit more for you guys not watching the content and watching me. If you are, thank you so much. Ethan Ampadu recovers the ball here. Archie Gray, Leeds United just in their own half here. Joe Rodon receives the ball on the back foot. Rodon looking to spray the ball to Junior Firpo, finds him. Sheffield Wednesday applying a press now, the Danny Roll press, which is to get their midfield high up the pitch and to try press on whoever they play. And it's worked really, really well, evidenced by 5 wins in 6. And 5 wins fully deserved as well. They've played well of Sheffield Wednesday. Ilan Melier net here. I'd like to see him go long a little bit more, because we've seen success when he goes long. Hasn't gone long here. Leeds playing, trying to play out from the back. Junior Firpo then goes long. It's a poor ball, a very, very poor ball, straight to Sheffield Wednesday. They recover the ball. Firpo wins it back in his own half, goes long again. finds Jorginho Rutter. Jorginho Rutter tries a splitting pass, loses the ball. Sheffield Wednesday pick it up. This pitch is nothing short of abysmal, which is once again going to negate any real form of Leeds United application on the ball on the floor. They keep going back, Connor. Yeah, come on, Leeds from Australia. I think it's going to be a tough night. This, if I think what we've seen success already when we've gone a bit long, when we've switched the ball a little bit quicker. I think the issue I have, and you guys know that I have with this Leeds setup, is I think we become a little bit predictable when the midfield just laterally passes and nobody takes a risk and we're safe. That's why you see Joe Rodon. That's why you see Ethan Ampadu moving into the midfield, because they give us those options. Anyway, Willy Nyonto is on the ball here. No real options for him. Willy Nyonto goes back. Leeds United have the ball. Joe Rodon again. Ethan Ampadu again. Someone's going to have to take a little bit of a risk. I know it's early on in the game, but we're seeing a few similarities here to what we saw early on. Let's see Leeds get the ball in the midfield and actually turn out and run at the centre-backs. That's what I kind of wanted with Archie Gray here. But Leeds have got possession. We know this. Greve plays it back there, where, in my opinion, he could have turned out. But it's okay. We keep moving. This is going to force Joe Rodon and Ethan Ampadu to step into midfield, because we won't go. We won't switch the ball out wide. We will always pass it on the floor, short passing. Anyway, Krasnici Somerville's come inside now to try infiltrate play. We play it around the back now. Again, Joe Rodon, Archie Gray, Willy Nyonto. No, nothing really for Willy to go out there. Goes back to Joe Rodon, Ethan Ampadu. For you guys who want commentary, it can be a little bit stale sometimes with Leeds United when we just have the ball and have the ball, which is fine. But anyway, Gruev on the floor, Archie Gray, back to Gruev. Gruev on the ball, Gruev, Kamara goes forward, better, incisive. It's a shocking ball from Willy Nyonto when it could have been so simple. It's a 10-yard pass from Willy Nyonto, splitting. Archie Gray is doing a really, really fantastic run. And I personally wouldn't have gone Nyonto, and as you guys know for this, I wouldn't have gone Nyonto and that doesn't, you know, I'm not the Oracle, it's a fan opinion. I wouldn't have gone Nyonto and Gray for this one. I'd have gone Gray in the middle, and I would have gone Robertson James. I just think there's a little bit more there. I think there's a little bit more distance between the two. I think there's probably a little bit more partnership between the two as well. And I think he's gone with youth and a bit more maybe exuberance over experience in this sort of game, which I'd have gone with probably Byram over Firpo, but it is what it is. Sheffield Wednesday coming this left-hand side, and now ball played in. It's another corner to Sheffield Wednesday. Another member, James Hockler, shout out to you, my friend. Hope you're all good. Matt Jace has come on Leeds. How bad Nyonto started, Connor? He's not been bad, mate. He's not been bad. I just don't think he should have started. James and Roberts, in my opinion, deserve the start. Corner to Sheffield Wednesday here. There might be some of you guys who are in front of me. It seems like you are. I'm on, as you can tell, I'm literally on the minute above here. Ball going to be played in here. Ball switched in by Marvin Johnson. Ball played in the box. It should have been 1-0. I don't know how Sheffield Wednesday haven't scored there. Guys, why can't we defend corners? Why can't we defend corners? You know, I don't want to be a martyr. I don't want to be negative, but I've got to be completely transparent. It is absolutely horrific defending from Leeds United from a corner ball. It's deflected in. Who's lost his man? It's Jorginho Rutter on that near post. Bamford and Rutter on that near post are horrific when it comes to defending corners. So, so bad. Sheffield Wednesday should be 1-0 up there. I don't know if Eli Melier palmed that. I'm not blaming Melier for that. We've just got to get better. I don't know. I know Bielsa, it wasn't a big thing that he did in training. But I'm really, really disturbed at points by how poor we are at defending corners. Anyway, we've got another one to defend here. It's an in-swinger. They're not going short this time. It's Barry Bannon to whip the ball in, whips it in, and Leeds defend it this time. It's on the edge of the box and it's fired over. I just don't really understand the pat. So when you defend in a corner, we have nobody on the outside of the box. So you'll naturally get opposition players lining up on the edge of the box for a rebound, for a second ball, if the opposition player knocks it down or you know, whatever. Something else happens, a deflection or whatever. Leeds just don't seem to do anything from corners in that respect. So I really don't understand it, to be honest with you. I'm not a coach. And, you know, maybe that's where I shouldn't comment, but it just looks a little bit more simple than maybe than maybe I would illustrate, than maybe it seems, really. It seems Leeds make corners so, so complicated. It's a throw-in anyway to Leeds United. Two corners already. I agree, Martin, scruffy game tonight. And we've got to be careful. Leeds in the building saying the same thing. We've just got to... I think everybody, being positive, for Junior Firpo's coming on this left-hand side now. Firpo advancing, the nice little run. Somerville, let's try find him again. We've gone back again. Glenn Kamara, go forward, Glenn, if you can, mate. Well done. Lovely little change of pace. That's much better from Glenn Kamara. Junior Firpo then gets the ball and goes all the way back. So, do you see what I mean, everybody? When there's a little bit of a press on, Joe Rodon stepping up here. When there's a little bit of a press on, Leeds seemingly just regress quite a lot. Greaves tried to switch the ball and knocked it out of play. You know, I think I don't really blame Gruev for that. I don't blame Gruev for that. He can't get, like, when we have corner takers, we have about four different corner takers per game, which naturally means that the corner takers can't really get a proper understanding on how to connect with the ball. And practice makes perfect. Sometimes you're rusty on your first corner. But then we don't play switch balls. We don't switch the ball at all. Junior Firpo's given the ball away in an absolutely atrocious position. Ball forward here. Sheffield Wednesday in a really good position. It's deflected out for a corner, and this is not good. Masaba knocks the ball out. Ethan tries to galvanise the crowd here. Junior Firpo with another absolute Durbrain error. And Sheffield Wednesday don't have the quality to be able to impact Leeds there, and it's knocked out. Good defending from Ethan Ampadu. It's another corner. Wednesday's fourth corner of the game inside 20 minutes. And they've got we're not weathering a storm as such, but it's Huddersfield all over again so far. Barry Bannon knocks the ball in, well out from Leeds. It's a poor corner from Bannon, and it's knocked out for a Leeds United throw. And this lot are nowhere near good. They're a poor team, but we are not doing what we said we should be doing at the start of the game, unfortunately, which is disappointing to see. Junior Firpo plays the ball back. And we have the ball at the back again. We need to start taking some risks. It's 20 minutes in. We don't need to panic, but I'd like to see Leeds be a top two team here and actually force the action a little bit. Lovely ball from Joe Rodon. Rutter, what can he do? Really poor ball. Sheffield Wednesday intercepts it here. Sloppy, everyone, is the word I would use. Sloppy. Wednesday on the right-hand side now. Masaba against Firpo beats him too easily. Ball played in, knocked out by Ethan Ampadu, does well. Junior Firpo, Rutter loses the ball for at least the third time in 10 minutes here. Got to hold on to that ball. Sheffield Wednesday steaming through the middle. Too easy. Great tackle from Ethan Ampadu. It's got to be better in that midfield. It's got to be much better from a defensive perspective and an offensive perspective. We've got to be a little bit more combative in there. Stop playing it back to the centre-backs. Get the ball. Open your body. Be brave. You're a Leeds United football player. You are better than these players. I am putting you above Palmer. I'm putting Gruev above Palmer. You know, I'm putting Glenn Kamara above Palmer and Bannon. You know, we've got to start seeing our central midfield has been a bit braver here. Archie Gray on the ball. And it's not crisis, guys. It really isn't crisis. And I hope you don't get the impression that I'm overreacting and being overtly negative here. I promise you I'm not. We just need to start being a bit better in ourselves because we're a better footballing team than this. We're a better team overall than this. As I say, it's no negativity from me. I promise you it's not. Glenn Kamara, ball forward, much better from Glenn. Patrick Bamford does really well. Bamford here in the Sheffield Wednesday box. Holds on to it fantastically well, Patrick Bamford. Can he get a corner? Gives away a free kick. He needs players round him there. Patrick Bamford has a long ball put to him. Where's the team? So just to paint you a picture, let me Picasso to you guys. Patrick Bamford receives a long ball. We're almost just not set up for these long balls. We're just not set up for them. It's almost just, and it actually, it's just shown the chance from Elion. It's a wonderful save from Ilan Melier. But we're not set up for these long balls. Patrick Bamford receives the ball, nods it, like, you know, receives the ball in their penalty area. There's nobody around him. So what is he going to do there? He's not a miracle worker. I don't blame Pat Bamford for that whatsoever. Got to start getting in and around him a little bit more here. Winning those second balls. Ethan Ampadu on the ball now. Moving into midfield. We know why he's doing that. Because the midfielders don't go forward. Joe Rodon on the ball now. Rodon trying to do that as well. Does well. Junior Firpo. Rodon takes two players out the game. Junior Firpo on the ball has to be better, Firpo. He's had a poor start. Crescencio Somerville's been doubled up on, as we saw in the Huddersfield game. Plays the ball back. Glenn Kamara, really nice ball. Glenn Kamara's had a good start, in all fairness. But I would like to see him doing a little bit more. Kamara should win a free kick. Doesn't, loses the ball. Sheffield Wednesday have it in there. Good tackle from Junior Firpo. Much better. We give it away again. Goodness me. Goodness me. I'm just going to gauge the chat. I want to hear what you guys are saying. Yeah, I can't do anything about that, Liam, unfortunately, mate. It's just my stream. Leeds don't need to be sloppy. This simply isn't good enough. I'm come on, Kamara, just get mugged. At the moment, don't look like a top two. So I'm interested to just gauge it, everyone, because I always find it fascinating, because sometimes you guys hammer me a little bit, and I understand that, and I'm trying to be a little bit more reserved here. But I genuinely don't go at Leeds because I'm like, oh, F Leeds, all this sort of stuff. I do this because I know this side's potential. I used to go at the Bielsa side because it'd do my nutting because I knew how good they were. But let's have a look at this match stats already. They've had four shots, we've had one. And we've had 70% possession, and we've had one shot. They've had four shots and a key opportunity. This is exactly how it was against Huddersfield. We had the ball, they had nine shots in the first half. We've got to start being braver on the ball. We've got to start being more incisive. Ethan Ampadu moves into the midfield. Options, Leeds. Options. Nonto is too inverted. He's too inverted. Needs to be hugging the touchline. Ethan spreads it. Wonderful ball. Really good ball. And Firpo's just completely misjudged it. It's a good ball from him. That's your fault, Junior. Your fault. Completely misjudged the ball. This is where Dan James, I just felt... Dan James would have been better here because he's not always coming inside to receive the ball, everybody. What we know with James is he's always going to run in behind the fullback. He's not going to come toward the ball. And I feel with a slow back line that is Sheffield Wednesday's, that would have been perfect. And not only that, but he hugs the touchline. Willy Nyonto is always looking inverted. That's why everyone talks about him being number 10. Junior Firpo tackled way too easily, gives the ball away again. Here comes Sheffield Wednesday surging forward, ball played in. Oh my god, and Leeds win a free kick, ball whacked across the face. Obviously I can't have that. I mean, Junior Firpo again, two of their opportunities. Two out of the three opportunities they've had have come through him. It's a wonderful ball across, and Nonto wins the free kick. Oh dear, everyone. It's Ampadu with the long ball there. Brilliant ball. Is Patrick Bamford onside? I don't know. Is Bamford onside? Bamford's made this harder for himself if he is onside. Ball fired across and nothing been made of it. I think Bamford thought he was offside there, and what he's done is, and the referee's given a foul. Bamford's bemused. It's not a foul, but in the modern game, I mean, I cannot believe. I mean, look at the reaction. The Sheffield Wednesday player has gone rolling around on the floor. He's evidently trying to get Patrick Bamford sent off here for a high tackle. Bamford's not put a high knee in whatsoever, a high foot. But let me just take you to the phase of play beforehand. The ball was played over the top. Ethan Ampadu has been the best player for Leeds so far. Bamford's in. And he just has, he must think he's offside. So he slows down completely, enables the Sheffield Wednesday player to get back into the fold. But Bamford then wins the ball back and then goes in with a tackle. And it's a really excellent tackle. He's absolutely nowhere near the man. He actually puts the slide tackle in before the man even gets there. And then the Sheffield Wednesday player rolls around 500 times trying to get him sent off, as the player on the other side has already tried to do with Crescencio Somerville. So we know the game plan. It's to absolutely shithouse the game and score from a set piece. And, you know, you've got to give credit to Sheffield Wednesday because, once again, as we did with Huddersfield, Leeds are not playing their way. We're not playing our way at the minute. And I don't understand what the game plan is here, to be honest with you. Joe Rodon gives away a foul. I think that was Ethan Ampadu, actually, to be fair. Donation in. Liam says, I was just letting you know about the times code. I'm not trying to... Oh, Liam, don't be daft, mate. Don't be daft. No, I'm not... I don't take offence to that, my friend. I really appreciate that. I just Firpo gives away another corner here. No, I'm not taking offence to that, my friend. Don't worry about it. And I appreciate you letting me know about the times. It's more a frustration on my end, to be honest, mate, because I can't speed this up. Anyway, it's a Leeds United corner. I wish it was a Leeds United corner. It's Sheffield Wednesdays. I think it's their sixth or seventh corner of the game. Barry Bannon whips it in deep this time. Not a doubt by Joe Rode on once again on the edge of the box. No Leeds man there. And it's a goal kick. Let me just talk to you about this. Oh, there is a head injury here. And it's Joe Rode, and I think he's bleeding. And it's Junior Firpo and Joe Rode on. Firpo's heading Rode on in the face. So it looks like there's going to be a bit of a stoppage of play here. Let's hope they're all right. We know the concussion rule now, where, you know, players do have to come off if they're feeling a little bit jaded. Looks like Joe Rodon's okay. Firpo looks a little bit worse for wear here, which isn't good. But as there's a break in play, everybody, I just want to get your thoughts. I just want to get your thoughts on what's going on so far. Are you agreeing sort of with me that it's this is pretty poor? I just want to get your thoughts. Evening all. Hi, Rich. Hope you're good, mate. Michael says, no shots on target, no crossings to the box. How do you think they're going to score? So this is how I see it, mate. And for you new joiners here, I think this is how I see it. You're just a little bit better on set pieces. It's dead simple. In terms of defending them, we have nobody on the outside of the box for second balls when it comes to defending set pieces, which is a major worry for me. You've got Rutter and Bamford on the front posts, and they barely win anything from that front post. Everything is Joe Rodon. So it's my major concern. I wish he'd have 6'1", 6'2" players, man for man. That's what I'd have. But I see Willie Nyonto and Kristensen Somerville on their biggest players, which is a massive worry for me in terms of systematically how we set up for corners. Another worry for me at this moment in time is Willie Nyonto isn't hugging the touchline. And when he's not hugging the touchline, that means that Leeds aren't as expansive. I think if we're able to get the ball here and we're able to move the ball quicker by switching the ball out wide, instantaneously, Calvin Phillips-esque, get the ball, one touch, switch. We're able to move quicker. Sheffield Wednesday then don't have the ability to move their entire unit across the pitch. If somebody's playing 1, 2, 3 passes, Sheffield Wednesday just do that. Move with the play. Easily move with the play. And when you have Gruev and Kamara, who aren't the type to get the ball and drive through the middle, we're not able to really infiltrate Sheffield Wednesday whatsoever. We're not able to do that. So Sheffield Wednesday have set up just like Huddersfield did, just like Rotherham did in the first game, just like Coventry did, Stoke, Sunderland. They're all implementing a very similar game plan. Waste time at points, work for set pieces, foul leads when they can, which Huddersfield did to a greater extent, but disrupt the game, which is happening right now. I mean, this is Leeds' fault, but disrupt the game, add time on, and that blueprint is naturally going to work. So I see systematically a little bit of a problem here. I would have started James because I think he'd have been more expansive. I think Leeds, that you'd have got Ethan Ampadu getting the ball and been able to put those balls over the top because the central midfielders won't do it for whatever reason, but Ethan Ampadu will. He takes it upon himself. And I see Dan James and Connor Roberts is a little bit more effective on that right-hand side. Robertson, please. You explain tactics so well, mate. Do you know what it is, Paul? I just see it from a... I could be wrong. It's just how I see the game, mate. I don't take it off anyone else. I just see the game in a certain way. I could be wrong. Listen, all my only accolade is that I've got a couple of coaching badges. That's it. Kaiser says, always like these podcasts. I enjoy listening to all the podcasts you do. Keep up the good work, mate. Thank you, buddy. Keep the comments coming in, everybody. It's great to see loads of you. Rodon's back on the pitch now, so we'll get the old timer back on. We're on about 32, 31 here. So... I've just put Leeds bloody 2-0 up. Apologies. That'd be nice, wouldn't it? Let's get the timer back on. We're on about... Let's get you guys back in. Yeah, that's us. That's us. So that's where we are. If you want to get your timers, this is shocking, mate. Says Stephen Brown. No idea how we win this. Interesting stat you mentioned in your recent video about Leeds switching and the lack of when we have Bielsa. Yeah, MW. Yeah, it's a very different... It's a very different way of playing. A lot of people see similarities between Farker and Bielsa. And there are to an extent, but yeah, they're both wedded to a... Bielsa was wedded to 4-1-4-1. Farker's wedded to 4-2-3-1. But overall, when you look at in possession, yeah, they both like to keep the ball, but Bielsa was a lot more, in my opinion, of the Klopps, a lot more dynamic. I think Farker is a little bit more of the Pep Guardiola's. Just keep it, and try pass the opposition to death. But we don't have as good a team as Man City, unfortunately. this isn't a good half from Leeds. Anyway, let's get back into it, everybody. I don't want you guys getting bored in here. Please make sure you're liking the video if you're enjoying. But let's get back in. Sheffield Wednesday, I've got a throw in here, and we've seen a long throw come in now, Conor Roberts style. I don't know who this is. Marvin Johnson, it might be. Oh, no, it's the right back who was throwing himself around after a minor contact. The right back evidently has a massive throw, and he's launched it. It's not that big, to be fair. Puts the ball in. Sheffield Wednesday win the second balls, and it's knocked away by Glenn Kamara. And Leeds have forced it all the way back to the goalkeeper, which is really good pressing, good defending. Barry Bannon, who's getting more and more in the game, unfortunately. He's finding a few more pockets. He's coming deep. He's heading out to the wing. Exactly what we said on the preview, really. Archie Gray up against Marvin Johnson. Marvin Johnson gets the better of him, and Barry Bannon wins it in the midfield again. The worry now is Sheffield Wednesday winning the second balls. Barry Bannon, again, you're hearing that name and hearing that name. Leeds aren't getting to grips with him. Bannon does well, plays the ball in. Ugbo on the ball now. Fends off the Leeds man. You've got to be stronger there, Grev. Grev's had about four goes at him. Finally gets the ball. Sheffield Wednesday receive it, but then Ampadu comes away with it. Ampadu's been Leeds' best player by a mile today. Ampadu does well. Patrick Bamford out wide on this left-hand side. The pitch has been a big problem for Leeds. It's skidding up a little bit, but it's like that for both teams. Bamford gives it straight back to Sheffield Wednesday when there was a simple ball on. Sheffield Wednesday come away with it. I've got a bad feeling right now. Firpo with a good tackle. This is an absolute shit fest of a game. The pitch is shit. The game's shit. Rutter's been a ghost. Somerville's been a ghost. Leeds' key players aren't on the ball again. This is a game where you need to be good with a set piece. This is a game where Leeds need to have a set piece and it has to go in off their arse. Brilliant little interchange there. Crescencio Somerville has the ball now. Bam. I think it was Diaby there. Moussa Diaby comes in and puts a really good tackle in. But better by Leeds. A little bit of quick interchange there. Somerville brave on the ball. Nice little Cruyff turn. Takes it past. There should have been a book in there for Saba, I think it was. But it's a good tackle by Diaby, and it's a Leeds throw. But better from Leeds. Quicker. More incisive. Because I can tell you what, everybody, so far, this has been shit. Mind my language. As you can tell, I'm getting a little bit more annoyed by this. The first 30 minutes, I was all right with it, but this is getting a little bit irritating now. We're not getting our better players in the game again. I need to see a lot more from this Leeds side. Kamara, because we have a better team than this lot, evidenced by the money that we've spent, the wages that they're on, and I need to see some key players stepping up and not hiding here. Grev is running towards the ball a lot, but I need to see Grev actually getting the ball and distributing it. Willie Nonto on the ball. Comes inside again, has a strike on goal, and it looks like that's dribbled towards the keeper. This is what I see. It's the difference with Willie. It's constantly inside. He's constantly inverting. And that is where, you know, I think technically he's a better footballer. Sky cameras are focusing on Bannon at the minute because he's probably the most involved player at the minute, which is a little bit of a concern for Leeds United. Sujal says, we do not need a downturn in form at the business end of the season. Ipswich have had theirs and have turned the corner. Bielsa never waited for 60 minutes to make a sub. Just ask Calvin Phillips and Pascal Strauch. Yeah, true, mate. True. No offense to Joe, but Joseph should be on 100% Connor. Connor, I'm starting to think Rutter needs a few games rest. Yeah, I'm. The thing is, mate, I don't think you're wrong. I don't think you're wrong, but I don't understand what other option we have at this moment in time. Oh, dearie me. Leeds win a free kick. Somerville, Kamara. Somerville. Archie Gray. Nonto. Cuts inside again. Somerville. Archie Gray. Gruev. Ampadu, lovely ball, Ampadu. Brilliant, Rutter's in. Rutter's in. It's a brilliant save. Not a brilliant save. It's poor from Rutter. Should be 1-0 Leeds. Really good opportunity for Rutter. And anyway, lovely flick by Rutter. Archie Gray, ball in. Beyond that of Patrick Bamford. Really good opportunity for Leeds there. Ball was flighted over the top by Ethan Ampadu again. Now, maybe the tactical beauty of this is the fact that Greb drops deep and allows Ampadu to come forward, but I don't think it's as specific as that. I think Ampadu is just taking it upon himself to be brilliant in terms of those advancing passes. Ampadu is the best player we have in the midfield, and he's playing at centre-back. Just an excellent footballer at this level and someone who I greatly appreciate. I'd love to see our midfield doing what Ampadu can do. He's switching it again. Brilliant from Ampadu again. It's another lovely ball. Jorginho Rutter's in, and I think he's offside. But he's making that run beyond the line now. With Sheffield Wednesday pushing up everybody, with them doing that high press, they've also got a high line, which means Leeds United can effectively put that through ball in. Now, Leeds have done that with Ethan Ampadu, and the keeper, Beadle's done quite well there. He closed Rutter down. I don't think Rutter, in all fairness to him, could have done much more. The keeper was off his line very, very quickly there. But these are the opportunities that Leeds need to take in these games. We had a couple of them against Huddersfield. Somerville hitting the post, a couple of others when we just got in on the turn a little bit, on the underlap and the overlap. And we didn't take those chances. This is a massive game for Leeds United. It's a really big game. We've got to win this game. Draw's not good enough, but it's good that Leeds are coming into the game a little bit more, I feel, everybody. You might agree, you might disagree, but I feel United are coming into the game a little bit more, which is good. It's good news. Archie Gray on the ball now. And Leeds have just cut out about four of their players. Can we do something here? Archie Gray, it's a terrible ball, Archie. You got to put more on that fella. Straight to a Wednesday player, and the Wednesday player can't kick for Toffee. Leeds have won the ball back here. We've got to play the ball quicker. I know the pitch is awful, but you paid 40, 50 grand a week. You've got to be good enough to deal with this. I mean, if Barry Bannon can deal with it, Leeds United players should be able to deal with it. What irritates me, though, is when Barry Bannon goes to the floor, even though he's about 4 foot nothing and he gets no touch on him whatsoever, he goes down and he just gets free kicks. Bannon. And let me just speak to you guys on this, on how mobile this midfield is. You've got Marvin Johnson, Bannon, and Palmer, Liam Palmer. I think the average age there in that midfield is about 38. I need to see more from our midfield. I need to see more from our midfield. I know they're congesting that midfield. I know they're in a severe mid block, and it's more difficult for Leeds. But when you've got that as a midfield three, I need to see more from Gruev. Gruev in particular, I think Kamara's done all right. Great ball in. Willie Nonto, Archie Gray now on the overlap. There's no options, though. We're not in and around him, everybody. You know, Archie Gray gets in the middle. Where are the options? It's a brilliant ball from Willie Nonto, but where are we? You've got... There's one Leeds player in the box. Where's Junior Firpo there? Firpo needs to be dying to get in the box. Somerville needs to be dying to get in the box. Bamford's marked by four Wednesday players, and we've now seen that two times. When we get into these positions, we have to have more options in the box. I need Somerville breaking a neck to get in there. Gruev or Kamara, get in the box. Nobody's in the box. Somerville. Ball in. Over the bar. Rutter. You've got to break your neck to get in the box. I wonder if you guys are of the same opinion there. Interesting to hear what you guys think on that. But, you know, if we get into these little interchanges, these little spots, let's have players breaking the necks to get into that penalty area. Four or five players in there. That's been a few occasions now where it's Bamford and that's it. What do we think is going to happen? You know, I feel sorry for the lad. I do. There's no way he's going to do anything there. But Leeds are getting into it a little bit more now, which is good to see. We're pressing a little bit higher. But it has got the hallmarks of another very, very tight Yorkshire derby. Sheffield Wednesday coming forward here on the right. Ugbo, Bannon, back to Ugbo. Leeds win it back. Opportunity in transition here. Rutter unlucky. Bamford, it's very, very scrappy. And are they going to win an offside here? Somerville into the box. Somerville, change of pace. Ball in. And it's out for a Wednesday throw-in. We've just not been good in attack, everybody. I don't think we look threatening. is probably the best word I would say, you know, which can be attributed to this. I don't think we look dangerous. I don't think we look dangerous. We've had definitely more possession in the half, which has been great. But if I'm a Wednesday fan right now, I'm not really like overly threatened by this Leeds performance so far. We need to see a little bit more. We need to see a little bit more. Ampadu's our most dangerous player at the minute. And because the commentator, he's just lost it. And that is an absolutely abysmal decision by the referee. Abysmal decision. He's booked him, the clown. Is this a yellow card? It's not. I'm not having it, everyone. I'm not having that as a yellow card. I'm not. It's soft. Ampadu yellow carded. 8 for the season. It's quite a bit. Quite a bit. 869 of you in the building. Please make sure you like the video, everybody. Just gives me an indication that maybe you enjoy these sort of things. It's a one-off for me, the Yorkshire Derby. Bannum. Free kick. Ball in. I mean, they're offering... I know they've had 4 shots, but they're a poor team. They're a poor team. Come on, Leeds. Goodness me. Where's that ruthlessness we saw before the Leicester game? No, even Plymouth, to be fair. It wasn't great, was it? Plymouth, Leicester, Huddersfield. It's not been brilliant. Best game we've played in the last month has been Chelsea, hasn't it? Rodon. Hoofs it. It's to Willian Yonto, which says it all. Poor from Rodon there. Grove wins it. Kamara goes back to keeper. Of course he does. Listen, Kamara's been the better of the midfield too. Grove's frustrating me, I have to say. He's too tidy. He need, like, look, I love that. I love how tidy he is, but he needs to be taking more risks. He's too safe. Nonto wins the ball anyway. Goes back into danger, but Leeds coming forward. Kamara, Somerville. It's got to be a bit of quality here before the half ends. Somerville. Rutter. No. Just those two trying to play in amongst the penalty area, which has worked for Leeds, but it's crowded out there. Kamara loses it. Nonto. Before the half ends, Leeds have got to do something quickly here. Nonto. Somerville. Purple on the overlap. Ball played in. Corner Leeds. Come on. Come on now. Jesus, have we even had a corner? I think we've had one, haven't we? Now, let's attack the corner a bit differently. Because we hit the front post every time because we have 5 different corners per game, corner takers per game. Somerville now, if we're going to hit the first post, which I would say we are going to, if we don't, great. But if we are going to, someone needs to attack the front post. And we've gone short. Nonto. Somerville. It's Kamara. Somerville. Kamara. Just come on, Leeds. Let's get the ball in the box or have a shot. Do something here. Kamara, on the overlap. Don't set a goal kick. Fucking hell. And that, everybody, is symptomatic of Leeds United overcomplicating actions. Kamara gets the ball on the edge of the box. Shoot. Doesn't. Cuts it inside to Somerville. Muck about with it. And then it's just easy to defend. Take a risk. From corners, let's be innovative. Let's be creative. Let's see a little tactic. We are getting stifled here. And we are showing nothing, really. If we're being brutally honest, it's poor. It's really poor. The blueprint stop lead is so obvious. It's literally just low block, compact, everyone behind the ball. Yeah, and just mid-block. Mid-block as well. It's... we can't corner. It's too placid. I don't know who'll take the corner, mate. But just sort of anyone who, you know, we'll get. If someone takes a corner, they can build up consistency game by game, minute by minute. Build up the corner consistency, the striking of the ball. You know, aiming. I know it sounds daft, but are you a corner taker who does it deep, who does it near post, or can you do both? But like Barry Bannum does for Sheffield Wednesday, you have one corner taker per game. We have about 5. And I don't think we have a plan, really. Anyway, Leeds win it back, lose it. We're just getting drawn into their game again. Leeds win it. Here, let's go quick. Firpo inside. Fucking hell, loses it. Wednesday win it back. Throw in Leeds. Ampadu back to keeper. Grev, go forward. Back to fucking Melier. Sorry, mind my language. Mind my language. Adam Forshaw. The Bulgarian Adam Forshaw. And that's not a negative. You know, it is the sort of player he is. But Ampadu, I cannot believe some people are talking about, you know, Grev over him. Rutter, it's a good tackle. Bam, Diaby's had a good game. Kamara, Leeds need something. Somerville holds it. Nonso. Firpo. Good ball. Bamford. Fantastic. Brilliant. Much better. Get in. Have that. That's brilliant. Brilliant timing. Oh, my God. I think we're all going into that half with a state of absolute, oh, my goodness. Brilliant time to score. Great anticipation by Patrick Bamford. Firpo, you know, it's the best action of the half from Junior Firpo by a country mile. Gets the ball out of his feet. And that's what we've been calling for. That is what we've been calling for. Get the ball. Whip it in. It's a brilliant ball in. It's an excellent ball in. Bamford's there. It's an excellent finish as well on his weaker foot. Instinctive. There in front of, I believe it's Palmer, is it? Looking for an offside. It's nowhere near offside. And that's what you get with a left-footed left-back. Listen, I'd have started Byram in this 100%, but that's the beauty of what you get with Firpo. It's a left-sided left-back who is a stronger left foot. It's a lovely whip. It's 1-0 Leeds United. And it's a great celebration from Patrick Bamford, it has to be said. Leeds go 1-0 up just on the half. Fantastic stuff. Excellent. Yeah, and listen, has to be said, it's not been good from Leeds this half. Not been good at all, but that is the moment of quality. And brilliant. End of the half. That's what you need. Great for Bamford. Great for a bit of confidence there. Really poor half from Leeds. Let's not get away from that. I'm not doubling down right now. Poor half, but a moment of quality at the end, provided by Junior Firpo and Bamford with an excellent bit of anticipation. I want to see the midfield in the second half get a grip of the game a little bit more. It's a bobbly pitch. We don't want to see a set piece go in. Guys, for me, it's just going to be a little bit of analysis when it comes to full-time as well. If you want to hear my full analysis, please check in then. But for now, I'm just going to have a quick half-time break, but I'll see you for the second half and hopefully a Leeds United win. how are you all still here? I've made a mad judgment. And I'm looking at Rutter now, and he should have scored, unlucky. But I'm making a mad... I've made a mad error. And you're all still here. So thank you. I'm really happy at that. Thank you. I thought I was going to come back and they'd be maybe my brother and my dad watching me. So thank you. I'm stunned you're all still here. So thank you so much. Tell me how we've started. Because I haven't got a clue. I got a little bit excited. I've got some salmon on for tea. So I'm just scoffing that down a little bit. I didn't expect any of you to be here. Looked at the watch and I thought, oh shit, we're 5 minutes in. So I apologize to all of you lot. I sincerely do. So hello, welcome. Dan says, I'm a member of this channel because opinions aren't alienated. They're discussed by the community. And Connor, in an educated way, separates this channel from most. The Joseph and Bamford chat is legit. Thank you so much, my friend. Bob, Rutter. Oh, sorry. Dan, what a lovely comment that is. Thank you so much. And I've left for 5 minutes into the second half, and you've put a comment like that in. Thank you so much, my friend. But yes, I like to encourage discussion. I think a lot of people seem to... I hope you all feel like that. I really hope you all feel like that. And I hope you all don't think that your opinion is ever quashed. I always try to discuss it a little bit. Anyway, Sheffield Wednesday come down this right-hand side, and obviously they're pressing a little bit. It looks at this start that Leeds have started okay. I've just get a bit... I'm gauging from the comments that we've started pretty well, which is good. Firpo just giving the wall away. Bamford wins it back. Bannon in the middle. But first five better than the first 45. That's good. Connor's got... turn the mic up. Okay, I will do. No problemo. I'll turn the mic up. Let me know. Is that better? Are we all good? The mic is considerably up now. We've gone to 141. Let me know in the comment section if we're all good. But yeah, thank you so much. Really appreciate you guys sticking around. Yeah, really appreciate that. Yep, being okay so far. That's good stuff. Diaby on the ball now. I got... caught into discussing Gran Canaria and eating salmon with my partner upstairs. Sounded a bit weird, but yeah. Anyway, so Sheffield Wednesday ball on the right hand side. Barry Bannon, all good. Love the negativity. Don't be daft, Paul. It's not negative on the channel, my friend. It's not. I dispute you with that. As I said, I think the important thing is. Do you know what the important thing is with stuff like this? You can admit. You're big enough and ugly enough and old enough to admit when you're wrong. I think that's just so big in football. And form changes. You know, you might have said something about Dan James at the start of the season, and then he's improved form-wise. That is football. Like, it's what it is, isn't it? So, but yeah, yeah. I hope I welcome all opinion. Road on to Warrior. What time are you on, Connor? Yeah, sorry, mate. That for some reason we should be on around about the right time now. Hold on a sec, mate. Hold on. Bang on now, mate. Bang on. Bash. Bang on the money. Oh, Martin, thank you. Listen, it's horses for courses, isn't it? People love different things. Anyway, goal kick. We're going to be here as well with your post-match, everybody. If you fancy joining in for a little bit of chat afterwards, we'll get way more of your comments in. I'd like to just apologize for, you know, sometimes some of your comments might not get read out, and that's just because I'm trying to watch the game and provide like a little bit of analysis when I'm here. So, yeah, apologies for that. But the interactive show afterwards, we've got a fan interaction show afterwards. Please stick around. Anyway, Leeds United, Bamford. Oh, Bamford, play it, son. Just play the ball, Paddy. Oh, they should make a film, the light and the dark of Patrick Bamford. Anyway, Leeds United have the ball on the right hand side. Archie does well. Archie does well. It's a goal kick. It's not a goal kick. It's a throw in. Leeds 1-0 up. We don't expect that, do we? You know, it's a really, really good position that Leeds are in right now. When have Leeds ever scored on the half before? It just doesn't happen, does it? To take the game away from the opposition. That will have absolutely sunk Sheffield Wednesday, which is great news. Ethan Ampadu, I just love this man. I love Ethan Ampadu. Can we get a one-word review of Ethan Ampadu in the chat, please, for his season so far, everybody? And I'll put in the best comment. What a player. What an absolute player this guy is. The quality of the match is so bad. Do you know what I mean, mate? It's all I'm saying with the quality of the match is it's fine. It's absolutely fine how bad it is. But as long as we get through it, mate, at this moment in time, I don't care.
You are. Thank you. Thanks, man.
Cheers. Ball. Sorry, my French. Greve comes away with the ball. Goes forward. Rutter, who looks to have got involved a little bit more here. Rutter on the left-hand side now, just inverting. Interesting chip ball, which I don't think anybody thought he would do there, which is Jorginho Rutter in a nutshell. Kristensen Somerville with a little bit of muscle there. He's having a really good battle with the right-back here, is Kristensen Somerville, which is good to see. Solid, consistent. Look at these. Yeah, awesome, solid. Richard, I've no idea what that means, but looks more than a word, mate. Phenomenal, stupendous. Yeah, proper player, isn't he? Anyway, here we go. Somerville in the area plays a poor ball in. It's easy. Bambo Diaby at the back for them. He's doing pretty well. Anyway, Sheffield Wednesday come away with it. We're not out the woods yet. Colm Finn with the best name so far, new member of the channel. Shout out to you, my friend. Thank you for your support. Really appreciate that. Archie Gray wins it. Well done, Archie. We'll have a free kick there, please, referee. Yeah, and he gives it in his face. He gives it in. Go on, Archie boy. Archie boy, giving it in his face. You see that 17-year-old elite mentality right there, everybody. Premier League mentality. Marvin Johnson's on his way down to the Conference North, and Archie Gray's on his way to the Premier League. Tenacious, aggressive, passionate. Leeds. Exactly what this boy is. I love that. Archie Gray gets tackled and he's going at him. A 33-year-old professional in Marvin Johnson getting budgeoned out by someone half his age. I absolutely love that. Wins the foul from him and gives him a little bit of jip afterwards. Oh, Rutter. Lovely ball through. Nonto's onside. Nonto, finish him off, lad. Yes! Get in there! Love that. Yes. Beautiful. Great finish, Willie Nyonto. Leeds United 2, Sheffield Wednesday 0. One team in Yorkshire, boys. Go back home. Back to the Hillsborough dregs. Love it. Get in there, boys. Either side of the half. Leeds take the game away from the Dingles. Fantastic. Lovely. And I just love that from stat one. Archie giving it. Melier with a good ball forward. I tell you what, Pat, that's brilliant football. Pat Bamford, hold up play, excellent. Rutter with another assist. Love it. I love that. That is a perfect goal at championship level. Ilan Melier, long ball. Bamford pins the defender. Absolutely pins the defender. He can do nothing about it. His balance is excellent there. Knocks it off to Jorginho Rutter with an excellent, excellent first-time knock. Past the defender, Willie Nyonto stays onside and finishes with a plum. Fantastic goal by Leeds United all round. It looks simple. That looks really simple, but it's not. That requires a real technical ability from two or three different players there. And it started from Archie Gray winning a free kick from Marvin Johnson and giving him a little bit of chip. I'm all about that. Fantastic. Leeds go 2-0 up against the Dingles. And that's is what you call perfection. Get in there, Leeds. Brilliant stuff. Ball played in. Leeds knock it out. This is better now. Let's take it to them. Leeds look. You know, I know I did take a little bit of time here to get into the second half, didn't I? But Leeds, so far, the intensity. Farker's gone in and given him an absolute bollocking in that first half. Nice to see Rutter's found his level after stinking it out in the Prem. Nice to see you on a Leeds United watch along, you dog-bothering loser. Anyway, Firpo has the ball. Lovely ball up. Intercepted, but Leeds United playing really well at the minute. Rutter intercepts it on the assault here. Leeds United looking miles better. Rutter on the ball now. Nonto, we can tear this lot apart here. Come on, Leeds. They've gotten into their groove now. Ball in, Somerville. Oh, he's got to score. He's got to score. It's a brilliant save from the goalkeeper. One-handed save by Gary Beadle, Geordie Shaw. Leeds should be 3-0 up. It had to be 3-0 there. It's a really good save from the keeper, but Somerville's got to score. You take it away from him. You take the soul. The Dingles go back home after that. The stadium empties. Ah, dearie me. He's got to score. He's got to score. Ah, he really has. He really has. But Leeds in the ascendancy, this is miles better. This is what we can do. This is why we get frustrated sometimes, this Leeds United side, because, you know, we start playing our way and teams can't deal with it. Teams just cannot deal with it. You know, excellent stuff. Really, really good. So far, Leeds should be 3-0 up, and we can take it away from you with our quality there. And Wednesday don't have the quality. Listen, this if we'd have done this against the dog botherers, just taking our chances, taking the game away from them very, very early on, we had that chance, didn't we? And that's Premier League qualified, Willy Nyonto. Somerville's got to score. He's got to score. But against the Dogs, if we'd have scored within the first 2 or 3 minutes, which we should have done, Kamara and Somerville, they wouldn't have got in the game. It was Leeds are all over him here. Rutter, play the right ball. He's offside. I mean, it's a poor ball. It's a really poor ball by Rutter there. But Rutter's picking up the pockets. They've unleashed Rutter, unfortunately, Wednesday. They had hold of him in that first half and he's gone now. He's absolutely gone. Brilliant, brilliant stuff. He's in the bleachers. Oh, it's a brilliant save. I have to say it's an excellent save. Their goalkeeper looks like he has a shoulder problem. Yeah, I've got it, Paul. Don't worry, mate. I've got it. The Tisky's there. Anyway, Beadle at the back. 61 minutes in, I think we are. Oh, no, sorry. Apologies for the time. I have to keep the time on. It's really annoying. Hold on a sec, guys. Sorry. What time are we on here? I think that's about it. Yeah, you guys are on mine now. Sorry about that, everyone. Bash. Anyway, Leeds have the ball. Archie Gray. Leeds looking much better this half. Willy Nyonto looks like a player reborn all of a sudden. What a lovely ball that was to Cree Somerville, by the way. And then he just boots the ball out of play. Honestly, everybody, with Conor McGilligan, this is the coverage you get. Willy Nyonto's playing really well and then boots the ball out for a Sheffield Wednesday throw-in. But do you know why this is great as well? Because Wednesday drew with this lot. Leicester drew with this lot. And the beauty about this is, you know, and the game's not over yet, has to be said, but they've got some really good results of Wednesday. Really, really good results. And this is a home game. And this was a sticky one for us. And it still could be a sticky one for us. It still could be a sticky one for us. But, you know, Leeds have come out in this first sort of 15 minutes and I wasn't here for five of them. But in the 10 minutes I have been here, Leeds have been really good. Leeds have been really good. It has to be said. We look more confident. We're all right with the height. They look more bothered about us in that high press, to be honest. Oh, Somerville with a poor touch. Greve wins it back. Kamara wins a free kick. Well done. Well done. Getting nasty. Game is perfect. Bobby. Bobby Schmurder. It's a great comment. It's a great comment, mate, and I completely agree with you. I think Matteo Joseph right now, whoo, the Wendy's are angry. It doesn't, and Chronicles in the build. This is what happens, mate. It doesn't. Oh, the throwing stuff. I love it. You just give it. I'd be horrible there. I'd be an horrible, horrible, horrible footballer. I would. I'd be not nasty as in, like, you know, hurt players. I wouldn't be that, but I'd be giving it to the crowd. On as a Leeds player, I'd be giving it. Leeds fan, Leeds player. You'd be giving it, wouldn't you? Be like that. Taking the game away from you. Back home to your shed. You've got to be, haven't you? You've got to give it to the Dingles. And Matt Smith comes on, I think. Wednesday making some changes here. Someone educate Michael here, everybody, in the comment section below. Always call them the Dingles, mate. Triple sub. Yeah, listen, we can do damage here, can't we? What we can do is I think you bring on Dan James for this one. I think you bring on Connor Roberts, and I think you bring on Dan James, Connor Roberts, and Matty O'Joseph, and just sink that knife in. Really well played. Ethan Ampadu intercepts the ball. Kamara doesn't read it, and Wednesday win it back. Wednesday with Matt Smith here, the problem is with Wednesday's pitch now is we've played through it on a couple of occasions. Sheffield Wednesday can't play the ball on the ground. So they're really struggling here. Ethan Ampadu. What's the crowd like, everybody? I can't hear anything. I can see it, obviously, but what's the away following like here? Joe Rodon gave the ball away there. Really poor. Junior Firpo does well there. Bamford holds it. Wins a foul. Well done, Bamford. Matteo Joseph time, I think, for me. Yellow card for Sheffield Wednesday at last. Keza, I would, mate. I would, but I've spent too long out. Listen, I came back 5 minutes late. For all you people who were just coming in for the first time, I came here 5 minutes late. Pause. So I have to say I apologize for that. First of all, I have to say I apologize for that. I can't go get it. Oh, hold on. I'm sorry. I think I've found a glass. Let's pour. Kaza, I found the glass. Now, how are we going to pour this? Is this going to go well? If you were here for the first half, the beer review, Tisky's getting a 9 so far. And we're going to do beer reviews on the watch along a little bit more. I'm going to give it a 9. Crisp, sharp, a little bit like Matteo Joseph, but a cold edge, a little bit like Chris Somerville. Now, can I pour this? Can you see? Sorry. Can I pour this with... I'm just going to see if Leeds have a chance here and then we'll pour again. Kamara. Still waiting on the pour. Will Connor do an ice cream or will it be as flat as a pancake? Cree Somerville. Jinx inside. Lovely. Cree. Lovely. Nonso. Throw in. Okay, so here we go. We're going to go with a little bit of a heightened pour. Will that kill the fizz? We bent on the side here. Used to be a bartender myself. Now, the glass is relatively cold here. And I have to say, it's not a mucky glass. Now, I appear to have poured a bit of an ice cream here. So, not great. Has anybody got a flake? But Leeds are not through yet. But will that ease down? Who knows? Anyway, we'll just wait for the beer review. Leeds are on the attack here, but that is a shocking pour. But I'm hoping I can just sort of top that up and we will maintain a little bit of head on top of that pause. Wait and see. 2 or 3 minutes. Somerville has the ball anyway. Jinkin, like he didn't do in the first half. Somerville on the ball again. Still with the ball. Crossing to Somerville. Pat Bamford here. Pat Bamford in the Sheffield Wednesday box. Leeds need to make the right decision. GG Somerville? GG Rutter. What a play that would be. GG Somerville. Leeds playing with a little bit more confidence at this moment in time, it looks like. It looks a little bit easy for them right now in and around the Sheffield Wednesday box. We'll come back to the beer review in just a second, everybody. Glenn Kamara with that famous check back. Firpo does well. Leeds get a free kick. So I've gone with it's not too bad. If you were here for the first half, you know how appalling that pour was. The bubbles are still there. So we'll wait and see how this develops. Staropramen, I can see in the chat. Yes, we know Staropramen is very good. We know it's very, very good. So, Tisky is rocket fuel. Anthony, it is. Favourite beer, Connor? I would probably go with a Tisky, you know. A Tisky or a Blue Moon. I do like a Blue Moon. Is this an Alcoholics Anonymous chat? Apologies for everybody who doesn't drink. That's absolutely fine, by the way. Anyway, Leeds United ball in here. It is Firpo and Somerville over it. Firpo with a chip ball in. Ball into the box. Good ball in as well. Nice ball in there, has to be said. Don't give it, referee. I'm not going to get stressed because Leeds are 2-0 up. Oh, guys, this... I'm sorry about this. To be fair, it's not too bad. I think the old stopwatch just stopped for a brief second there. But it would be great to see a lot of you on the post-match reaction chat as well, where we will get more of your comments in. I apologize. I am trying to watch the game and, believe it or not, commentate on it. But after the game, this is going to be a fan interactive chat. So please get your comments in. Really appreciate that. And we'll go through, hopefully, another Leeds United win over the Dingles. Marvin Johnson for Sheffield Wednesday. Bannon's got a lot. Do you know what the interesting tactical aspect of this is? Bannon's got barely any touches. He's got barely any touches in this half, which has been fantastic from Leeds United. It looks like Gruev is a little bit closer to him than he was in the first half. Could be wrong, but it looks like he is. Bannon dropping deep as a result of that, playing a lovely threaded ball through, to be fair to him. Bannon plays the ball out wide. He is head and shoulders above anything Sheffield Wednesday have, to be fair to him. And if he's not on the ball, then neither is Sheffield Wednesday, pretty much. But Bamford does well. And it is. I don't think Joseph's going to come on in this game, if I'm being honest with you guys. I think it's a physical, horrible game. And I don't think he wants him in a game like this, to be honest with you. Quick beer check. How we looking? Not too bad. Somerville. Firpo. Lovely. Okay, so I'm seeing a lot of you guys in the chat say something, and I'm getting a little bit worried at that. And this is why I'm trying to watch the game, because I want you to actually have a live reaction, and I don't want you guys to know that I sort of know what's going on. But I don't want him to wind me up here. Sheffield Wednesday have the ball. Joe Rodon's made a mistake. They've got through because Rodon's lost the ball. Poor from Joe Rodon. Here comes Sheffield Wednesday in the central space. In the central space here. Shot from distance. So it's not a goal, but it's Ilan Meslier. That's all I'm going to say. And some of you guys want him in the Premier League. Some of you guys want him in the Premier League. I'll take the abuse all day long for my opinion on Ilan Meslier in the Premier League. Barry Bannon on the ball anyway. Just to give you a little bit of a highlight of what went on there. It bobbled a little bit because of the diabolical pitch, but Ilan Meslier and Sheffield Wednesday have a really good opportunity here. It's brilliant defending from Ethan Ampadu. We've got to be careful here. But Ethan Ampadu mops it up there, but Ilan Meslier once again gets the crowd up. He gets the home crowd up like he did, like he has done multiple times this season, because of his sort of just has this tendency in him to have absolute howlers. And thank God it was cleared off the line there. The ball deflected, was cleared off the line from a simple ball from a shot from 25 yards out, which had no pace on it. And Meslier seemed to make that into a nigh-on howler from nothing. Worrying. Anyway, Sheffield Wednesday in the box here. Love a little piece of skill. And it's a Sheffield Wednesday corner. And suddenly, see, if this makes me feel like it does with Ilan Meslier net at points, I understand he made a really good save in the first half, but thank God, you know, he's made a good save. But if it makes me feel like this, how must it make the defenders feel? If he nigh on makes howlers like that, you know. And Ethan, let me just check this again. Ball struck. What is he doing? Thank God for, if Ethan Ampadu's not there, it's 2-1 with 20 minutes left. He palms it down into the striker's feet. Okay for now, out in the Premier League if we get there. 100%. Okay, so Sheffield Wednesday have come into it a little bit now. They've got a little bit of vigour after Ilan Meslier. See, the thing is with Meslier is what he's done there from a simple opportunity is he's got the crowd up. He's got the crowd up and he's given them a little bit of, maybe we're not out of this game. That's what happens with opportunities like that. But it is what it is. The ball's not gone in the back of the net. It's okay. It's 2-0. But my goodness. Do you know what, Paul? I'm not keeping tabs on it, mate. I'm not keeping tabs on the F1 at the minute, mate. Get to Aldi, £1.99 Rossini Grand Reserve, a strong beer. Tastes good. We'll do that in the next game, mate. If you want me to do another watch along, get the likes on the video, everyone. Get the likes on the video. I'm really, really humbled by the amount of viewers we have today. I really am. I expected my old man to be in the chat, maybe Gabe, my brother, and probably my girlfriend. So thank you so much for your support on the watch along, and I'm really humbled by all of you guys being here. Sheffield Wednesday come forward here. An absolute on Archie's gone over. Wednesday have a massive opportunity here, and it's a who's that? Joe Rodon. Sheffield Wednesday broke through there, and it's a poor decision, and Leeds United were able to make that recovery there. It's a shocking ball out and a shocking tackle as well. Looks like Wednesday about to get in the booking here. Barry Bannon's going nuts with the Wednesday plays. They had an incredible opportunity there, everybody. They had Leeds in the transition. Leeds, Archie Gray fell on the floor. A couple of other Leeds players were out of the game, and they had a real opportunity there to hit Leeds. And in the Premier League, we get hit 100%. It's a goal for whoever we're playing against. But Sheffield Wednesday just don't have the quality to do that. Hence why they are second bottom. We have got to remind ourselves that they are second bottom here. 75 minutes gone. I would like to see some substitutions here from Daniel Farke, but a real positive, everybody, if we haven't spoken about it so far, is the fact that Leeds United are going to be going into a big break now, eight-ish days, where with hopefully a win, which, you know, looks likely at this moment in time. Ryan, you were right, mate. Logan as well, not seen you in a while, mate. Toss up between you and Benjamin Bloom. You won, Connor. Thank you, mate. Watch along for Ngannou, Joshua. Do you know what the thing is, mate? I'll be in this room watching it. So I should have done it. I should be doing stuff like that. Would you guys be interested in a general football channel? I don't know if you would, but please let me know if you'd be interested in a general football channel as well as Leeds United bits. Anyway, Sheffield Wednesday come forward. You might not. And if you're not, I'm not going to do it because there won't be any interest there. Somerville has the ball. Somerville play the right ball. Somerville. Lovely ball carrying. Nonto. Can he get it? Nonto's got it. Leeds in their half. Oh, it's just wrong decisions. We've not really had anything since the second goal, since that brilliant save from Somerville, to be honest with you. Nonto. Farker changes, please. Firpo, Leeds are just conserving a bit of energy at the minute. It's got a bit flatter on it. I think someone was right in the... Leeds have an opportunity. Bamford with a poor ball. Paddy, it's got to be better there, mate. We are not in the 72nd minute. Apologies. It's I'm reading all your comments out. And we are also not 4-1 up. 4-0 up, I should say. Hold on a sec. We are 4-0. So I'd like to apologise for that. It's because I'm reading all your comments out and I shouldn't be doing that. I should be keeping the scorecard on. So thank you so much. But please make sure you're liking the video as well, everybody. We'll be doing Patreon content after this as well. But we've also got an instant match reaction, which is live, where I really want to get a lot of your thoughts in. Anyway, Leeds coming forward again. Sheffield Wednesday retrieve the ball back. We have 12 minutes left, including stoppage time. Enough time for Sheffield Wednesday to score two. Leeds have to be careful here. Matt Smith, Wednesday getting a few forward here. Good tackle again there. Who was that? And Leeds have an opportunity here. Come on, Leeds. I know it's a terrible pitch. Willie Nonto covered by Barry Bannon. Oh, lovely ball, Willie. Rutter's shot blocked. It's good defending. It's turned into a basketball game. Wednesday coming away with it now. Matt Smith. Fasawu. Skips Junior. Oh, Junior Firpo in the Premier League. We can't have Firpo in the Premier League. His 1v1 defending's horrific. Matt Smith. Barry Bannon. Ball in. Goal kick. Poor from Bannon. It's a £10 donation. Dan. Dan the man with the plan, the man who makes Connor feel fantastic. Thanks, Dan. Does that rhyme? With opinions like that on Elon and Bamford, you'll never get on Leeds group panel discussions. But honestly, both of them can be brilliant and useless in the same 90-minute period. Yes, mate, exactly. Thank you for your donation, mate. I appreciate that so much. Really appreciate that, buddy. Yeah, keep the comments coming in, everybody. Keep the comments. We're approaching the 80th minute now. Bamford nods it out, and it is Bamford's. I have to say, I wanted Joseph in for this one. I have to say that I did want Joseph in. I think Joseph would have been all right in this game. I think he'd have coped. But Bamford's been excellent. Been a really, really good game from Patrick Bamford. Really important game. And respect to a lot of you guys for saying it. You know, I was going on the Joseph bandwagon. I don't think Joseph would have been bad, but a lot of you guys were saying, nah, Connie, you stick with Bamford. And you were right. You know, you were. He's been truly, truly very good in this game. Hold up play has been excellent. Knock on for that second goal was very, very good. Hold up play, as I've mentioned, excellent. Yeah, he's been very good, has to be said. Sheffield Wednesday on the ball now. Barry Bannon, Marvin Johnson, Archie. Go on, Archie, son. Archie on that right hand side. Oh, excellent, excellent, excellent from Archie Gray. Jorginho Rutter, lovely little interface. Leeds playing it a little bit quicker there. Nonto halts the play a little bit and he's going to have to come back. But okay, Jorginho Rutter. And he's been kicked off the ball there and the ref's not seeing it. Rutter's down, Nonto's down in a heap. I love Nonto, but I think, you know, sometimes he doesn't massively realise that there isn't VAR here. And if he's going down in a heap, there's nothing's going to happen. VAR, something gets looked at, but unfortunately these horrendous referees, nothing's going to happen. But it's fine, bit of time wasting. So Nonto, let's have a quick look. What happens? I think he's just foot gets stamped on. Bit weird. Sujal, and here's another five for the coffers, Connor. Keep up the good work as always. Sujal, you're a top man. You're a top man. You've always been an excellent supporter of the channel. Thank you so much, mate. James goes, I've got Ngannou, TKO, round two. I don't think so, mate. I don't think that's going to happen. I think it's going to be Joshua. Joshua on points for me. And here are the subs that we were calling on 10 minutes ago. Roberts, Joseph, and Dan James, all coming on. The subs coming on. But thanks for your donation as well, Sujal. But yeah. And some of us coming off Nonto and Bamford. Yep, good subs. Don't mind that. I wish they'd have come on a bit earlier, but, you know, I am a perfectionist. I'd actually say some of us been the poorest of the three, to be honest. Nonto's been very good second half, has to be said. Very good. Bamford waiting until he comes off. Clapping. He knew what he was doing there. Fair play to Bamford. He's been excellent. Been very, very good. Very good, Patrick Bamford. I would like to say again, listen, when I was selecting Joseph over him, it's not because Paddy's poor. I think it's because I think Joseph's incisive. He's sharper. He's crisper. And that's just the point he's at in his career. But Bamford's been very good tonight. One of Bamford's best games, I think, this season. Very good indeed. Ampadu in midfield, yeah. Luke said, when everyone's fully fit, Connor, would you have Strouk or Ampadu next season? To be clear, I'd still bear Strouk, but I'd love Ampadu orchestrating things. He's a strong leader. Yeah, Luke, I'd 100% have Ampadu in midfield. He's the best midfielder in the division. Strouk, let's never forget how good Pascal was before he got injured. 13 out of the 14 games he played before getting injured, he was captain. Daniel Farkas called him the cornerstone of proceedings at Leeds United. And listen, Daniel Farker's picking him all day long at centre-back, and fair play to Farker for that. He should do. He's more than good enough. Pascal Strouk is a Premier League player, and Ampadu is an unbelievable midfield player. And we've seen by his passing ability, even when he's been playing centre-back, that we miss him in that midfield. I would be taking Gruev out and putting Ampadu in, to be honest. If you want my ruthless opinion, I'd be putting Ampadu in all day long. He's a better football player all day long than Gruev. But I don't mind Gruev, but he's nowhere near on Ampadu's level, in my opinion, in midfield. Anyway, Leeds have the ball. Wednesday putting on a bit of a press. Leeds playing it in behind. Joseph on the run around, and Leeds win a throw-in. Oh, no, they don't. It's been kept in. Roberts heads it out. Kamara loses out. Malik Wilkes has come on, formerly of Leeds United. Cannot believe he's still playing football. Diaby. Ball played in by Will Volks. Aiming for Matt Smith. Nodded out. Rodo's done a good job on him so far. For Saba against Archie Gray. Played it back, can't beat Gray. Marvin Johnson looks to put the ball in, can't. Wednesday, in all fairness, Leeds have neutralised a lot of what Wednesday have tried to do, which is great. And it looks like Perot's now coming on. I think Daniel's trying to kill the game a little bit now, which is great. Another clean sheet, if Leeds can keep it, would be fantastic. And it really puts the pressure on our opponents this weekend, our rivals. Leeds getting the win here. 5 wins in 6 for Sheffield Wednesday. I know the where they are in the division, which is second bottom, but it is a good win for Leeds, this. It is a good win. Bannon's been isolated this second half, which I don't think many teams have been able to do to him under Danny Rawl, the new manager. He's been given a free role. He's been popping up everywhere, and he's been very, very influential. Leeds have killed him in this game, which has been good. Second half, anyway. Anyway, Sheffield Wednesday, Malik Wilkes on the ball. Malik Wilkes puts the ball into the box, headed out. Bannon receives the ball. Puts the ball into the box. Nodded out by Junior Firpo. Firpo rifles are clear. Wednesday pick it up. Bannon again. Playing that long ball again. Leeds going to have to deal with that. Nodded out, and it is a Sheffield Wednesday. Come on, Wednesday! A Wednesday corner. As I say, everybody, please like the stream if you're enjoying it. It'd be fantastic for you to let me know that you are enjoying the streams. I don't do these that often, so please make sure. Maybe it's the timer that's the difference. You guys are here for the timer. Ball played in by Sheffield Wednesday. No, it's not. Volks. Nodded out. Leeds have, to be fair, we've dealt with a lot of aerial threat really well in this game. Ball played in again. Can Leeds deal with this? They can. Out by Glenn Kamara this time. Bannon. Nodded out, and
Joel Perot
is coming on. Look at Rutter. He's loving it. He goes off for Joel Perot. We all good, everybody? We all good? Wi-Fi dropped. We all good? We all good, everyone? I don't know. Blurry. Kamara. I might be back now. Might be back. Am I back? Am I back? Is he back? Good stuff. Cheers, guys. Sometimes happens when you're on like a 2-hour stream. Malik Wilkes. Oh, Wednesday have won it here. Wilkes. Yeah, it looks like it, doesn't it? Some Wi-Fi at last. Obviously, they're applying a little bit of pressure here, everyone. Ball played in. It is a corner to Sheffield Wednesday. Come on, Wednesday! 2 or 3 minutes left. I'll be back. Yeah, I'm happy this isn't happening at the start of the game. But guys, I will be back afterwards with a match reaction. Make sure you tuned in for that one. Hello. Nothing's happened. It's all fine. Leeds United corner. Oh, Jesus Christ. I'm back. But we will be back with your full-time reaction, everybody. We'll be back with your full-time reaction. Make sure you check it out afterwards. Hello, Loaf. Hello. Nearly got one at the end there, didn't they? Perot. It's a Leeds free kick there. So yeah, we're going to be back. We don't need the timer now, do we? We're done. We're nearly done. We're nearly done with this. And then we're going to be back with, as I say, guys, the instant match reaction. Get on over there and we'll get your opinions in, which we haven't managed to do. I want a refund. Oh, Paul, you're a hard bargainer, mate. You're a hard bargainer. All over. That's it, everybody. I'll see you on the instant match reaction. Catch me over there. Shout out, Nigel. Shout out, everybody. Make sure you like the stream before you leave. And I'll see you over there.